Hello friends, today I will show you how we can run Nginx in a Docker container, and I will show you how we can simply host a static website in Nginx. So without wasting any time, let's start this video. So what is Nginx? In short, Nginx is an open source lightweight software for hosting web application. So friends, first we need to install the Docker desktop. Since I am working in a Windows machine, so I will download the Docker desktop for Windows. So you can simply download from the Google Chrome, like just simply search for download Docker desktop for Windows and click this one, and you have this Docker desktop for Windows. So one thing to remember before you install the Docker desktop, make sure that your system meet all the requirements to successfully install the Docker desktop. And once your system meets all the requirements, the next thing is just click this Docker desktop for Windows, and it will download this execution file for you. Okay, once the Docker desktop is downloaded in your machine, you just need to run it and you need to install it. And once you have installed the Docker desktop in your machine, you will see a small icon, a Docker desktop icon over here. You can just double click, and at the moment, you know, like you can see the two containers running on my machine. If you are installing in your fresh machine, you won't see any container. And the other way to check if the Docker is properly installed is by through command line. So I will show you in a PowerShell. So in a PowerShell, you can simply run the Docker version, and when you run this command, you will see the client and the server. So make sure that, you know, like when you run this command Docker version, it show both the client and the server. Check and make sure that both client and server is displaying. Okay, the next step is to get the Nginx image from Docker Hub. So we just need to go to Docker Hub and search for Nginx, and here you will find a lot of, you know, like Nginx images, and over here you can also see some documentation regarding, you know, like what is Nginx and how to use this image. And if you go to tags, you will see there are lots of images. So for this video, let's use this tag. You can see the size is just 9.82 megabytes, so we will use this image. So first we copy this command, and we need to, so before we run that command, let's make a directory first. So I'll create a directory called nginx test, so we can simply run this command, and this will pull the nginx image from a Docker Hub. Already existed, so I think I have already pulled that image in the past, so I say it's already exists. So let me check. So yeah, so this may take a little bit of time in your case. So once you have this Docker image, you can simply run this Docker image command, and it will show all the images that are installed in your machine. So okay, let's run the Docker container now. So Docker run image, nginx, tagline, mainline, alpine, and let's run in a daemon mode, and let's map. So we need to this one daemon mode, and let's map the port, the default port that the nginx will use is port 80, and for host I will use 8080. So what does that mean? We are running the Docker in a detached mode, so the container will run in a background and we are mapping the port. So this is our host port and this is the container port, and lastly the image name, which is nginx with the tag 9. So now if we click enter, you'll see the container ID. So let's run docker ps and you will see the same ID over here, and if you check the status it say off 3 seconds. If you run the command again, you will see the nginx is now running. Now since we have mapped the port 80 with our host 8080, the next thing is just to check, you know, like if it is working. So localhost 8080, right? So you can see we have a welcome to nginx as some content. This is the default index content that you will see, you know, like when you install the nginx. So the next step is to, you know, like create your own static, you know, like HTML file and replace this one with that one. Okay, so firstly I will show you how you are seeing this content. So if you go to the docker ps again, and if you run docker exe interactive mode, and you can just use the three letter from the container ID, and let's run the shell command. So what it does, it execute command is usually used if you need to, you know, like execute the running container. So you have your container is already running, so you just want to enter into the container just to see, you know, like the file system within that container. So if you now type ls list, you will see there is a user folder. So just log to user folder, then log to share, and then log to nginx, and then log to html, and you'll see the index.html file over there. So if you just type cat index.html, you will see welcome to nginx. So this is the same file that you are seeing over here. So if you change anything over here, you know, like you will see the changes in over here. So we can simply test that by simply say echo and say simple text, and simply overwrite the index.html file, and if you now refresh, you'll see the simple text. So the content you are seeing over here is definitely coming from the index.html file inside this part, right? So the next step is we create our own static file, and then we will use the volume. So docker provide a volume option so that you can map, you know, the host file with the container one. So the next step will be to, you know, like create a simple index file, and then using the volume, you know, like we will map our, you know, like folder path with this container folder path, so that we can see the content that we have in the host file over here. So let's do it. So first exit from here. Okay, the next step is to create our own index file. So I will simply run my Visual Studio code and let's open that folder, which is nginx this, right? Now this one, right? So select folder later, and over here let's create one file. So let's say index.html file, and let's write some text. It's one. Welcome to Learn with Sans. Right, so we simply want to replace the existing index file with our own index file. So what we need to do is over here, let's stop this container first. And okay, so we will run a container. So first we'll run the Docker image. So let's run a new container, docker run. Let's run in a daemon mode. Map the port with, let's map the port in different one, let's say 081, and now we will use this volume. So we have our index file over here, so we just copy paste this column and the part where that index file is in a container, which is in a user share. And if I remember, nginx html, right? And lastly the image name, mainline alpine, right? Okay, so we have this container running, so let's check it in the browser. Finger cross. Localhost 8081. Right. So you can see our file over our index file where we create this text. You can see that text over here. So let's do some changes over here. So let's say Learn with Sans. Let's save it. See. So whatever you created within that folder, that will be automatically, you know, like created in the in your container as well, because we have mapped the volume. So to verify that, you know, like we will do a simple test. So let's say we created another page about .html, some funny text, and let's go to the PowerShell and let's execute interactive use that one 780, right? Oh sorry, so you also need the command. So let's run the shell command and let's go to that part. So cd user share nginx and html. So you can see there is a new file created over here. So if you create any new file over here, suppose I say echo, let's say Sanjay, and let's write in the sanjay.html, you'll see there are three files, right? But now if you check over here, you'll see the new file coming over here. So that means that we have properly mapped, you know, like our host folder with the one that exists in the container. And this is how you can simply use the Nginx to run in your container, and you can host your, you know, like static file using the Docker. I hope you like this video, and if you like this video, please give thumbs up, like this video, share this video with your friends, and please do subscribe my channel. Thank you so much. Bye.